Hello friends, now what do you mean by word sensors? As the name says, sensors means it will sense something. Now what it will sense? Any physical parameter like temperature, pressure, heat, and convert it into electrical parameter. Now let's see sensors in details. Now what is sensor? A sensor is a device which will convert any physical parameter like temperature, pressure, force, tension, etc. into an electrical output. Sometimes the sensors may convert this into another mechanical output, and those mechanical output can again convert it into the electrical output. Sensors are also called as transducers. They are called as transducers because they convert one form of energy which is given at the input to another form of energy which is output. Take an example of bimetallic strip. Now if bimetallic strip is getting heated, it gets bent. Means it converts one physical parameter, that is heat, into another physical parameter, that is movement, linear movement of that particular strip. So such type of devices or such type of things are also called as transducers, which converts one form of energy into another form of energy. Now sensors are generally used as input devices, or it gives input to any system. One of the example of sensor is our skin. Now our skin can sense touch, it can sense heat, it can sense pressure, it can sense pinching. So this gives input to our brain, and our brain reacts like that. So if it's too hot, my reaction will be, oh, it's too hot. So I have to turn on my fan or my AC to compensate for that particular heat. So sensor in embedded system will give input to the system. Now the example of sensors are thermocouple. Now what thermocouple does? It senses the temperature and converts into equivalent voltage. The next is RTD, resistance temperature detector. Now this will sense the temperature and change its resistance. That is, a change in temperature is converted into resistance. The next is LDR, light dependent resistance. So this particular sensor will convert light into change into resistance, that light which is falling on it into change in resistance. The next is light dependent resistance, LDR. Now as the name suggests, it will convert light into change into resistance, means the light which is falling is converted into change into equivalent resistance. The next example of sensor is piezoelectric crystal. Now piezoelectric crystal, when it is given a force or force is applied on it, it will convert it into electrical parameter, that is voltage. In our example, thermocouple, what it does, it converts the change in temperature to voltage. RTD, it converts change in temperature to change in resistance. LDR, it converts change in light to change in resistance. And finally, the piezoelectric crystal, it converts a change in pressure to change in voltage. So let's see different sensors and their functions. So the very first is LVDT or RVDT. LVDT stands for linear variable differential transformer, and the RVDT stands for rotational variable differential transformer. So what this sensor does, they convert change of linear movement or rotational movement into equivalent voltage. Second is optical encoder. Now as the name says, optical means it is related to light, so they will convert the change into light into some voltage or some digital values. The next is strain gauge. Now strain gauge will convert change in the load to the change in equivalent resistance, or change in pressure to change in equivalent resistance. Now piezoelectric crystal, change in pressure is converted into voltage. Thermistor, change in temperature is converted into equivalent resistance. Now photodiode or phototransistor, they will convert change in light into change into voltage. Next is inductance proximity sensor. So they will change the voltage when there is metal is detected. So a detection of metal will change the magnetic field, and the change in the magnetic field is converted into voltage. And the mic will convert your sound into voltage. Now let's see some examples where this particular concepts are used. Now, the very first is fire sensor, where photodiode is used. Now, when there is a fire breakout, that particular fire has some wavelength. That wavelength is detected by photodiode and it is converted into voltage. The next is moisture sensor. Now, in moisture sensor, there are two metallic probes. When these probes are inserted into soil, it will detect the moisture of the soil, and that moisture will change the resistance, and the change in the resistance is converted into change in voltage with the help of that particular module which is connected with the moisture sensor. The next is obstacle sensor. Now, in obstacle sensor, there is a photodiode and there is an infrared LED. Now, what they will do, they will sense the object in the proximity. They will sense the obstacle in the proximity. The next is sound sensor, which will convert your sound into voltage. The sound sensor will convert sound into voltage, and they're based on capacitive principle. That is, my sound is converted into change into capacitance, and that change into capacitance is further converted into change into voltage. The next is gas sensor. Now, it works on the principle of thermal conductivity. Means there is a heater, and above heater there will be gas passed. The moment the gas is passed, gas may be LPG, gas may be oxygen, it may be carbon monoxide. The thermal conductivity of all these gases are different, and thus when it is passed through the heater, the heating and the cooling of the heater is changed, and which will change into resistance, and this change into resistance is further converted into voltage. In this way, different gases are sensed with the help of different thermal conductivity of that particular gas. And the last is optical sensor. Now, already I have told you one obstacle sensor, which is optical sensor. This is another optical sensor which are used in printer basically to sense whether my head is at the home position or not. Or they can also be used to detect opening and closing of the doors. Optical sensor generally consists of an infrared LED and a photodiode. Now let's see some sensors one by one. Now the very first is resistive sensor, that is strain gauge. Now, strain gauge is a sensor whose resistance changes with the applied force or pressure. So, on the strain gauge, when the force is applied or pressure is applied or tension is applied or load is applied, it gets deformed, and thus deformation of the strain gauge is converted into change into resistance. So, strain gauge is basically is used to measure stress or strain. Stress means internal pressure, and strain means the force which is externally applied. So in the diagram, strain gauge is shown, and what is stress and strain. Now, application of strain gauge, where they are used. Strain gauge is most widely used in weighing machines or in the load cell. Now, in the load cell, there are strain gauges on which the load is applied, that is a weight which, or the object is placed, which we have to measure. And this object, when it is placed, it will deform the strain gauge. Deforming the strain gauge will change the resistance. So, change in the resistance will be equivalent to the object or the load which is placed on the load cell or the strain gauge. So, they are used in mechanical engineering to measure stress, to measure vibration, to measure torque, to measure compression and tension moment. They are using weighing scale, as I have told you. They are also used in the field of component testing of aircrafts like linkages, structural damages, etc. So you can see the application of strain gauges. The first is load cell, and another example which is shown in the figure is weighing scale. Now, what strain gauge does, when the load, pressure or tension is applied, it converts its equivalent change in resistance. Now, resistance cannot be directly measured. So in order to measure that resistance, I have to convert it into some electrical parameter, that is voltage or current. So when I have to convert into voltage into current, I have to use into some electrical circuit. And that electrical circuit is nothing but Wheatstone bridge. A Wheatstone bridge is 4-arm bridge. Now, in that bridge, either in one arm you can use the strain gauge, or in two arms, or in four arms. In Wheatstone bridge, there can be one gauge, there can be two gauge, or there can be four gauges. You can see one gauge and two gauge in the diagram. Now, how to interface this strain gauge to my microcontroller? Now, strain, when it is applied, it is an analog quantity. So it will do the change in resistance, that is also an analog quantity. So that again, it will convert it into a change in voltage with the help of Wheatstone bridge, that is also an analog quantity. But my microcontroller cannot understand analog quantity. So when I want to interface my strain gauge with my microcontroller, I have to use a component which is called as analog to digital converter to convert that analog voltage from the strain gauge to digital voltage. Now let's see where these components are there in my diagram. So in my diagram, this is Wheatstone bridge. This Wheatstone bridge is connected with the help of load cell. The next component is analog to digital converter. Now what this does, this will take analog input. So analog input are taken from here. So this analog voltage is converted into digital output. So this digital output is here. And this digital output is given to microcontroller. Now what microcontroller will do? It will process that and it can display on the display. With the display may be either LCD or LED. Now take an example of same system in weighing machine. Now in weighing machine, there is my load cell. On the load cell, I place the load, that is weight which is to be measured. So here I'll place the load, and once my load is applied, there will be deformation in the strain gauge. This deformation is converted into voltage. This voltage is converted into digital value with the help of this analog to digital converter, and finally it is given to my microcontroller. Where my program is running, that program will take this digital value and convert it into a format which is to be displayed. So at the output, what I can do, I can connect display. Now this display can be a 7-segment display, what you see generally in our digital weighing machines, or they can be LCD, that is liquid crystal displays. So this was about the strain gauge. So we have seen the application, how strain gauge can be used in digital weighing machines. Apart from this digital weighing machine, strain gauge can also be used in measuring the torque. Now torque is nothing but the rotational force. The next is optical sensors. Now the moment I say optical, optical means it is something related to light. So they will convert the light into some electrical format. So optical sensors, what they do, they convert light rays into electronic signals. Now what optical sensor does, they will convert the light which is they are receiving into some format which is readable by the machines or by the controllers. Optical sensors are generally used for contactless operations. Contactless means I have to detect the obstacle. So I did not have to hit the obstacle for that. If there is an obstacle in between, automatically my sensor will notify that there is an object. Second application of optical sensor is counting the objects, or counting the tablets, or counting the bottles. One of the best example of optical sensor is IR optical sensor, and IR stands for infrared. This IR sensor consists of one infrared LED and one photodiode. Means I cannot see the light rays which are being emitted by that LED and received by that photodiode, but I can feel the change in voltage when there is obstacle, or when the light is reflected, or when the light rays are reflected. Optical sensors are of two types. One is transmissive type and other is reflective type. Now in transmissive, the transmitter and receiver are at different end, and in reflective, transmitter and receiver both are at the same end. Let's see one by one. Now reflective type of optical sensor. So in reflective type of optical sensor, the transmitter as well as the receiver both are at the same end. Now what the transmitter will do, it will transmit the infrared rays. Once the infrared rays are transmitted, there will be obstacle. So once it hits the obstacle, the rays will be reflected and it will be received by the infrared sensor. So as seen in the diagram, the rays are transmitted and when they hit the target, it will be reflected back, which is received by the photo diode. So there will be change in the voltage. So what is done, the light rays are converted into voltage. So in the figure, you can see different types of reflective optical sensors. So this first one can be used to sense the obstacles. The second can be used to sense black and white strips. And the third can be used to sense opening and closing. Now let's say my printer head, when printer head is moving, it will come to this end. When my printer head comes here, the light is obstructed, and since the light is obstructed, it will halt at that particular point. This particular is transmitive type of sensor. This is transmissive type. So the second is transmissive type of optical sensor. So in transmissive type, the transmission is done from one end and the reflection is done from the other end. Now when there is transmission of infrared rays and if it is received by the receiver, definitely there is no obstacle in between. So when, as long as the light rays are received by the receiver, there is no obstacle. The moment obstacle cuts the light, what will happen, it will get obstructed and it will get the indication, or it will give the indication to the receiver that there is something obstacle in between. It is as shown in the figure. So when there is transmission and reception clearly without obstacle, the light will transfer from one end to another end. But the moment there is an obstacle, there will be obstruction of light, and this obstruction of light will give the receiver indication that there is some obstacle in between. So in case of reflective type sensors, both are at the same end, and in case of transmissive type, transmitter and receiver are at the other ends. So we can see transmissive type of optical sensor. So let's see where this optical sensors can be used. In object counters for counting the objects, proximity sensors to detect the obstacle, fire sensor to detect the fire breakouts or the fire nearby, burglar alarms which will indicate there is any burglar or any person who is trying to theft the home, radiation thermometer to find out how much heat is being radiated from your body, human body detection, that is again the obstacle, gas analyzer, radiation detection, obstacle detection and avoidance. So you can see the fire sensor which has photo diodes, and the fire emits one particular wavelength. That wavelength is detected by this photo diode. Next is pyroelectric infrared, that is PIR, motion sensor. Now this detects presence and absence of human being. Now where this can be used? This can be used to save the light. Now take an example, in a room all lights are on, and if there is no movement of a human being for a long time, this PIR sensor will detect that, that is, there is no movement, and it will switch off all the lights and keep the minimum light on. So this is one of the simple example of PIR sensor. The next is obstacle detection and avoidance. Now in this IR sensor, when there is an obstacle, it will give the written signal, and this signal is detected by photodiode, so I can avoid this obstacle. Now where it can be used? It can be used in small robotic devices or robotic cars, where car is moving, if there is obstacle, it can auto, it will change its direction and move further. Now these are interfaced with microcontroller. Now since it is optical sensor and it is having only two state, that is detection and no detection, so it can be directly interfaced to my microcontroller. Now let's see how it is interfaced. Now as I've told you that IR sensor or the optical sensor has only two state, that is detection and no detection. So here I've taken example of detection and no detection. Since it is giving the digital output, I can directly interface it with my microcontroller. Let's see how it is interfaced. This optical sensor has three pins. One is for VCC, other is ground, and third is the data pin. So presence and absence of data can be given as logic high and logic low. So how it is connected? Let's see. So this is obstacle sensor. This obstacle sensor is connected to pin 1.0 of microcontroller. So when there is no obstacle, let's say it is giving logic 1. So what my program will do, when it is a logic 1, it won't take any action. Let's say LED is glowing and buzzer is buzzing. So when the data is 1, means there is no obstacle. When there is no obstacle, means LED is off and buzzer is also off. Now the moment it detects the obstacle, it will change its state. How it will change its state? It will go from logic 1 to logic 0. The moment my program detects logic 0, what it will do? It will buzz the buzzer and glow the LED, which I have written in my program. So I can give the output on buzzer. Same way, this obstacle sensors can be used to control doors. That is, when it is giving 1, means nobody is at the door, so door will be kept open. The moment somebody comes at the door, it will change its state to logic 0, and that door can be opened as soon as some person comes. So it can control a motor. Means when there is logic 1, no person, motor is off. When there is logic 0, the person is at the door, so motor will move and open the door, and after some time it can again close the door. This is how my interfacing can be done of IR sensor. So there are multiple applications. Now same way, I can use here fire sensor also. That is, presence and absence of fire can be detected. Same way, I can use PIR sensor, where presence and absence of human body can be detected. So the another interfacing is PIR, that is PIR sensor. Let's see the interface of PIR sensor. Now what is the function of PIR sensor? It detects human absence and presence, that is in a room. It is interfaced in the same way as I have interfaced my obstacle sensor. Even PIR sensor has three lines, or the three pins, one for VCC, one for ground, and third is the data pin. So this data pin will go to logic 1 or logic 0 depending upon presence and absence. So in my diagram, if you see, there is a PIR sensor. This PIR sensor, through the transistor, it is interfaced to microcontroller. So this is my transistor circuit, and output is shown on LED. Even I can connect this output to buzzer also. So this can also be used as a burglar alarm system also. That is, during the night time, if there is nobody in the room, LED will be off, no buzzing will be done, and the moment somebody comes into the room, it can start buzzing. So it can detect the presence and absence of human being also. Thank you.